How's it going, everyone? Your boy Corey here, aka Crasher, back with a new video. And ladies and gentlemen, we have ourselves a rather serious topic to get into. Now, we have ourselves an article on Dexerto that is titled, xQc reveals he had to move out after daily police swattings. I was scared I was going to die. Holy shit. Let's see what we have here. Twitch star Felix xQc Langill revealed to viewers that his house in Texas had been swatted almost every day over the last few months. The popular streamer explained that he almost moved back to Canada due to fearing for his life. During his June broadcast, xQc hit back at accusations that he was moving back to Canada for gambling after his DMs with train wrecks were accidentally leaked online a few days earlier. The former Overwatch pro opened up to viewers and explained the real reason he wanted to go back home was due to being genuinely scared after being swatted by police almost daily. xQc explains how swatting made him move out. In early June, xQc and Adept surprised viewers when they moved in with fellow streamer Soda Poppin. At the time, the couple explained that the move was only temporary due to house renovations. However, on June 28th, Langill revealed that the real reason was due to him being the target of a dangerous harassment campaign. The main reason I wanted to move back to Canada a month ago, we were getting raided by the police station at rates that absolutely made no fucking sense. Almost every day, the police came to our house with the full squad because of fucking idiots. And I was genuinely scared that I was going to die, the 25-year-old explained emotionally. He then alluded to facing other situations that were even worse than the swatting. It didn't make sense to me, and I just got so scared I wanted to go home. I just wanted to go back to Canada, and then some other stuff happened that was worse. Way worse, and I was like, I want to get the fuck out of here, he said. While xQc didn't elaborate further on what the way worse things were, he clarified that he was able to come up with a system that let him stream live without viewers knowing that police were raiding his home. The police here are very professional. After the first raid, they would give us a heads up and they would clear the house, and I found a way to remain on stream and not say anything at all. And nobody ever noticed, and the streams kept on going, he said. The streamer added that when he would look off stream and mention food, it was often a signal to the police that everything was okay. Anytime I looked to my left and I was like, the food, yeah? Sometimes there were full fucking police squads in my house. The signs the streamer had been going through a serious situation in real life have been hinted at during past streams. In previous chat logs, Langill had written, dealing with in real life shit again, it's piling up, I need more time, sorry chat. Stop thinking that everything is easy going, man. Offstream has been a fucking nightmare. It's a miracle I go live at all. Langill added that he didn't want to be seen as a victim and that he initially didn't speak up about the situation due to not wanting to validate those swatting him. However, the star felt that growing accusations that he was only moving back to Canada for gambling reasons put his back against the wall. At the time of writing, it's unclear whether xQc still has plans to move back to Canada. However, the popular Twitch streamer has stated that he moved in with friends in Texas due to genuinely being scared for his life. Okay, so I don't really know about the whole gambling thing that is brought up here a few times, so I'm not going to talk about it. But what I am going to talk about here is how absolutely ridiculous this whole thing is. I mean, how hard is it to say in plain simple English, stop fucking swatting people? Like, people have gotten killed from these sort of things. As a matter of fact, this here is an example to further back up how dangerous swatting is. An Ohio gamer gets prison time over a swatting call that led to a man's death. So you guys get the idea. Those of you guys that are viewing here that have a good head on your shoulders, I know you guys understand this. But it seems like I have to spell it out for those that think that swatting pranks are fucking funny, just to have a little bit of attention in their empty-ass pathetic lives. Like, do these people even understand the amount of lethal factors that are within that situation by swatting someone? Like, you have absolutely no idea. And if you did, and you still think that shit's fucking funny, What in the blue hell is wrong with you? But you know what? Let's actually put the shoes on your feet here if you think shit like this is fucking funny. How would you feel if you got swatted? If a loved one got swatted? If your close friend got swatted? And what if it resulted in death? Would you still be laughing now? Probably not. Like, I shouldn't even need to make a video on this. I shouldn't even need to say something so rudimentary and so easy and straightforward to understand, but it seems like that there are idiots out there that think that swatting someone that could potentially lead to their death is fucking okay. What? Are you that deprived of clout and attention? Did your mommy and daddy not raise you with enough tender love and care? Like, you gotta act like a complete asshole and do this type of shit? Like, what the actual fuck is wrong with you? And here I am fucking sweating. It's not just because of the fucking heat wave that's going on right now. I am pissed. I am absolutely heated that something like this is still going on to this very day. And hell, here's another example. Review Tech USA had to deal with swatting as well on stream. And I can only imagine, like, I can't even begin to imagine, actually. Let me correct myself. I can't even begin to imagine the amount of fear and anxiety that people have to go through when they are face to face with a group and a SWAT team. Like, that's gotta be some scary next level shit right there. And honestly, I think these people that wanna do these fucking garbage ass SWAT pranks just to have a little bit of clout and fame and attention for themselves, they should be jailed for attempted manslaughter, because check me out on this. There have been people that have died because of these swatting pranks. So the person that committed the act should be charged with manslaughter and should be jailed for a very, very long time. Anyways, ladies and gentlemen, I don't think I need to say anything more about this subject partially because of the fact I'm really heated right now. And I don't think I can go on without wanting to go off. So I'm gonna end the video off here. I think I've more than proven my point here when it comes to all that I've shown and talked about here. So I want to say thank you guys very much for watching, and to xQc, you know, I'm really sorry that you had to go through this stuff, like, on a fucking daily basis, too. You know what I'm saying? That shit is not okay, and I don't give a rat's ass if you are a fan of xQc or anyone or not. The absolute last thing that you should do to anybody is pull shit like this that can get people killed. Like, who fucking cares if you have a beef with Joe Blow or Jane Doe? Who cares? Somebody's life is not worth fucking beef and a prank over. Anyways, guys, video's finished. Thank you guys very much for watching, and thank you for your time as well. Have yourself a damn good one, and I'll see you guys in the next video.